So hello, what's up YouTube? It's me, Unspeakable Stream Tips, and I'm gonna showing you how to live stream step by step. Let's take an intro first. Entry. You better love me again. You better love me again. So this tutorial will be how to stream on OBS step by step. So first you need to do, open your OBS studio, or before that you need to download it in your browser, any browser. So I'm gonna show you where you can see the browser. So I'm sorry for that one. So as you can see, there's a OBS studio. Just search, or I'm gonna send the link. So here's the OBS Studio. As you can see, this is OBS Studio. So it's easy to download. You can download it on Windows, Mac OS, or Linux. I don't know what Linux means. I think this is for other PCs like Mac. Okay. Premier sponsors, we have Facebook, Twitch, or YouTube. So gold sponsored is own 3D Pro. So features, look at this one. They have all the mixers, powerful to easy, and set up unlimited number of scenes. You can switch between seamlessly via custom transitions we have here, and then we have high performance real-time audio capturing, and then etc. Okay, now let's go to your OBS Studio. So we are now at the template. So we're gonna go here at Sim4, and then I got my templates here. So here's my outro, by the way. So we're gonna add some scenes. So first you're gonna need to do, so we're gonna just turn off our video capture here at Streamlabs. So we're gonna just get it off, and then just gonna place the Twitch here first. Wait a minute, guys, and I will be gone. So today I'm gonna show you now how to set up your video capture first. So just press the right click button here, just press the right click and press add, and just find the video capture device. So add existing one. So no, just create new. So just find general webcam or like that, etc. There's many lots of general webcam. So I'm just gonna turn on this back again. Where is it? Cancel. We're gonna delete. Where's the delete button here? So as you can see, we don't have a webcam. There you go, we're back again. So as you can see, there's nothing here. There's nothing. I'm just gonna place here, by the way, on the top. So right now we're just gonna press this settings one, the settings. Okay. As you can see, here's the stream step by step. Just first general, just click the language English, the theme dark, or the system, there you go, it's white or Rachi. Let's kind of mess it up like that one. So English, Rachi, then Arky. There's lots of settings, and I like this OBS Studio. It looks cool, man. So let's go apply it. This is my settings, by the way. It looks like a Facebook gaming. So just scroll down and just find your audio. So let's go to your stream. This is the really important, and I'm living at Twitch. So okay, now let's go to your output first. So the output one, we gotta choose this NVIDIA NVIC H.264U. This is the latest one, and just apply it. So the recording one, and we have 1440p resolution. That was awesome resolution, highly recommended for higher and high-end PC. For low-end PC, just choose the 720p. Okay, so here's our settings, by the way. So for high-end PC, just choose this one, and if you are using a normal PC, just tune it down like this one. There's lots of choices here. You can choose like 720 to 540 for low-end PC. Okay, so now let's go to your video. The video is the really important, like this is the biggest problem to your PC, like the resolution, the FPS dropping. Okay, there's lots of choices in their FPS value, so you can customize it to 100 common, like fractional, and you can make it like 120, 60 for customization, like that one. If you want to customize it, you can choose to 60 FPS. So integer, I'm just gonna use 60 FPS. For low-end PC, so we have common FPS. We got. You can choose here. Okay, you can choose here. What's called this? You can choose any FPS value. For low-end PC, just go to 30 to 10. To if you're using high-end PC, just go to 48 to 60 FPS, because your resolution will be bad if you're using low-end PC and you will choose 60 FPS. So just choose. I'm just gonna choose 60 FPS because I have a high-end PC here. So so next one is gonna go to output scaled resolution. So the resolution one you can choose here. Just press this little button here like an arrow, just click, and there's lots of resolution you can choose. You can go to 360. So if you have a lower PC, like lower PC, like low RAMs, like lower PC like that, so you may choose this 720 to 360. So if you have a high-end PC, just go to 720 to 1080. Just click apply, and I don't change anything here. So let's go press nothing. Okay, this one is the transition. So we got transitions here. So it's really nice to choose this one. The transition, you can choose a key bind for it. Like for example, let's go get out of here. So let's use the, for example, like this one. Let's go down. Let's go down, 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 down. If you want to go up, and here you go. It's gonna going back. So it's easy, guys, to change some to keybinds one. So let's remove it. So let's go to the settings again. So the keybinds, the hotkeys is one. There you go. This is the ending. Show browser hide like one. The god mode, just check that. This looks like an intro. The main one, you can choose many etc. Guys, let's see, like this one, that there's so many tricks I know. So okay, now let's go back to your output. So because sometimes you have lag internet, so go to your speed test. So speed test, so here goes the speed test. Okay, it counts your internet speed, the speed test one. So we're gonna go to your camera, so the side. So as you can see, 06.3, there you go. I got a high internet. Look, it's 205 Mbps internet download. So the upload is 200. Just wait it for it. Just wait for it, and you're just gonna wait for this one, and it's 5,000 bit rate for that one. If you have a low internet, just go to 1,000 to 4,000. If you have high internet, just choose to 5,000 to 100K for that one. So if your internet is only in the middle of like 200 to 100, just choose 5000 kbps. It's now better. So okay, just press okay here. So in here, our app bar, as you can see, there's a help tool, scene collection, profile, view, edit, and file. So the files is, you can show recording, remax recording, settings. So here's the settings, you can just click here for the easiest. So just click these tools and find the stats. There you go. As you can see, there's a stats button here. Okay, just click the stats. Then here you go. We got this one. So okay, let's go back to OBS Studio. So we're just gonna test my live stream. It is going good or bad. So let's go. Let's just click the start streaming. Connecting, and then let's go back to OBS. As you can see, we're running good. It's all white and it's good. It means your live stream is all good. There's no any problem in your PC. And if this white begun to red, it means your PC not doing good. He or she can do it. The work doing the system. So you need to maximize your settings first. So it's doing good and it's nice and it's running good. So as you can see, we have 1.4 ms and it's running all goods, guys. So we're gonna stop streaming. Stop streaming, by the way, and we're just gonna reset, and it's the stats is gone, by the way, and that's a video for tonight. Sorry, I'm not ready for this one, so let's go back to intermission. Okay, so if you enjoyed this video, just hit the subscribe button, the like, and the share button. You can share this to other or in your streaming program. You can share this video to learn more. Okay, guys, our next vlog is game how to live in Gamecaster. Gamecaster is a better live streaming app for low-end PC. You can live there like 60 FPS only using 1050 Ti. Just copy my settings, your stream will be awesome. Literally. So if your stream is so bad, just report me on YouTube and you can bash me anytime. So guys, don't forget to comment and I will heart your comment. And thank you guys for watching and see you all next time. Peace.